Pair subject as comedian Andy Cameron looks back over some great Rangers memories of more than three decades. We'll see you in a couple of minutes. Welcome back. Now, anyone who doesn't know the footballing allegiance of comedian and actor Andy Cameron must surely have been out of the country for the last few decades. He's taken the ups and downs of supporting Rangers in his stride, and always with a joke and a laugh. Earlier, Campbell Gray spoke to Andy about his long love affair with the Gers.
What about the 60s? What stands out from the 60s for you?
The 60s, my great memory was 1964, Rangers won the treble. And as you know, the Scottish Cup's the last game of the season. It's great to win the league. I think the league's the most important thing. But there's something about the Scottish Cup final. It's the last day of the season. And if you win it, oh, it's marvellous. And me and my two pals, Hector McGee and Willie McNabb, we were in the North Stand at Hampden. You know, the big high stand it used to be. And indeed, a really good team at that time. Bert Slater was the goalie, and it was known as Bert Slater's final because he was outstanding, he was magnificent. But the guys like Alec Hamilton and Bobby Cox, Big Ian Muir, and they had Kenny Cameron up front, Andy Penman, who later came to Rangers. They had some smashing players, and nothing each halfway through the second half, and Rangers have scored. You know, oh, your beauty, that's us, we've done it. A minute later, less than a minute, up the park they went, Kenny Cameron scores, one each. It's a real nick and tuck thing, you know. Bert Slater's pulling them out everywhere. Don't know how he's getting to them. You're exasperated, to say the least. 2 minutes to go, Jimmy Miller, Ralphie Brand, they scored one each, you know, in the last 2 minutes. You've won it 3-1, and that's it. They can't take anything away from you, and you've won the treble. I'll never ever forget that. And the strange thing about that is, might be a question in a Trivial Pursuit. Rangers won that without a Rangers strip on. They wore stripes, blue and white stripes, blue pants and red socks. And I can remember the team, Richie Shearer, Proven, Greg McKinnon, Baxter, Henderson, McLean, Miller, Brandon Wilson.
Oh, you've touched in the 60s. 70s was a good era for Rangers.
The two trebles. We actually nearly won three trebles because Jock left and then John Greg was the manager. And John was unlucky because we lost the game 4-2 at Parkhead, and that would have been us winning the treble. We won the Cup and the League Cup that year. Mind you, the Scottish Cup final that year was... Hibs, it was a marathon, I think it was. We won it in the second replay after extra time or something. It was incredible. But the 70s was a good era. Great players in the 70s. Big Derek Johnson. Who can ever forget his debut? You know, 16-year-old laddie. And winning goal against Celtic in the League Cup final 1970. One of the best displays I ever saw. Rangers playing against Eindhoven. 3-2. We lost 0-0. We drew 0-0 here. We lost a goal in 23 seconds in Eindhoven. And come back, and they scored, that made it 1-1. But we're still through. Then they scored, made it 2-1. We need another goal, we get it. And the last 2 or 3 minutes, and Tommy McLean shoved one right through Bobby Russell right under the goal. A great goal, and a great performance away in Europe, beating Eindhoven 3-2. I don't know how many times they've lost in Europe up to then, but they couldn't believe it.
Now looking at the 80s, and fill us in on your impressions of the
80s. I'm at that age, Campbell. I'm 57 now, and I can remember 40 years ago, but I can't remember yesterday, you know. And the 80s were a great time as well. There was a nip and tuck, Celtic would win the league. And I mean, everybody knew there was just that buzz about the place as soon as he's coming as a manager. And the best thing that happened to Rangers was Souness, the plain sense. The second best thing that happened was they went to Liverpool. Because mm-hmm. I think circumstances, I don't want to get into it, but I just think that I think he did what he had to do and it was done, and Walter took over, and Walter's been marvellous, absolutely magic, you know. It's just absolutely, I think what Walter Smith's done for the airplane squad is magnificent. And of course the chairman's taken over, and what the chairman, where the chairman's got it with the fans is he's up front. Mm-hmm. He come out and say, well, we're going to make 5 or 6 signings in the summer, and he did that. And look at the signings we've made this year. But back in the 80s, it was Terry Butcher, Chris Woods. And you go, jeez, they play the English internationals. They're coming to us. Wonderful. And you can remember Big Butcher when he scored that header. We drew 2 each at Bertoddy. We won the league. And that was the start of it. One of the greatest memories of the 80s was playing Celtic here. And I mean, the referee lost it. Frank McAvenny's first Old Firm game, he's trying to impress the Celtic, which is understandable, because mm-hmm. we want players to do that when they play the first game for us. And he's jumped on top of Chris Woods, and he started the fracas, right? The three of them's ordered off. It turns out in the court that Frank McAvenny gets away with it, and the two Rangers players have now got a blot in their copybook. But we're down to 9 men. Graham Roberts didn't know it was Dane, by the way, conducting it. He had no idea. That'd be a Scotsman, he'd never have done that. Mm-hmm. However, they've scored two, and I'm sitting here and I'm going, oh, here we go. I remember the 7-1 game, you know, in 1957. Mm-hmm. I'm going, well, like a game, you know, and I never leave, you know, I always stay at the end. And at 2-0, and then all of a sudden, we've only got 9 men, and we're starting pressing in the second half, and we get a goal. McCoy scored from here, come off the post there. And I said, we're not out of this shit, you know. And it's ticking away and ticking away. And see them at that end, all you could hear it was nails getting bitten, and it was unbelievable. And this, we were like, oh, yes, on you go. We Durant's got it out, and I think it was Goff that gave him, actually. Durant's got it out there, and he's crossed it in, and there's a scramble, and Goff's poked it into the net. Well, they thought we'd won the European Cup. But that was one of the, that was, we drew 2 each, but that was a victory.
So let's bring it right up to date.
The 90s. Last season, November, the Celtic were top of the league, you know, but in goal difference. And I mean, I was in amongst the Celtic fans that night because I was a guest of the Scottish television, and we were in the captain's table. It was great, we had a lovely meal and all that. And Tony Roper, who's a Celtic fan, and myself are sitting together, and the two guys for STV, Gus McDonald and Gary Hughes, the accountant. And the four of us sitting there, and it's all Celtic supporters running about us, and the usual cry, hey, wee man, don't you give us any of your patter here tonight, by the way. You come to see the hoops going to the top of the league, you know, and you just sit there and you say nothing. Mm-hmm. And if your team scores, you sit in your hands, inside you're going, yes, you're a beauty. And when you get home, you go, oh, you know. But when in Rome, if you'll pardon the analogy, we're sitting, right? And the big boy O'Neill slips, and Lloyd drops on to it like, Greyhound's got after the hair, and he's away with it, and he's stuck it in the far corner. And I mean, run about you, you could have cut the silence with a knife. And Euro Rangers then's going bananas, and I'm sitting there and I'm going, yes, that'll do us, you know. Now, see that night, to me, that showed that how much Loudrup loves this club, because he was like, ah, yes, because he was delighted to have scored. And I think they knew that, even at that stage. I mean, the second half of that game was still unbelievable. Two penalties saved, you know. The chances we missed, I mean, Big Bo and Peter Van Vossen, I could have ran out of standing scored, you know, but that's football, that's how it happens. And you look back in that game and you say, I reckon that was where we said, hey, the league's still ours, you've got a bit to go before you can take it from us, you know.
I think Andy just might be a Rangers fanatic.